Hey guys, this is the Irgo by Oh My God We're Doom. This is a small grid racing kind of ship thingy, but with a large engine. So, the Irgo cost 2,149 PC with 463 blocks. Alright, let's see here. We got some decorative elements using panels and neon tubes blocks here. Yeah, this thing is on a subgrid because it's diagonal. Some more paneling. Is that the side view mirror? That's kind of nice actually. A rather decent painting and texturing work by the creator as well. So this thing is asymmetrical. I wonder how these diagonal hydrogen thrusters will work to the top of the vehicle. Some panelings. And there's some of the internal components up here. That's the canopy hinge. Seems to be rather simple down here. Alright, that's pretty much the whole exterior. Let's fly the ship now. It's rather simple. That's a nice use of the programmable. That's a nice use of the small grid programmable block, by the way. We got two buttons on the toolbars. I'm guessing this close the canopy. Maybe this one. There you go. The canopy seal is actually pretty seamless. Yeah, that's pretty nice. Alright, let's fly. The forward acceleration is pretty amazing. Hold on, I forgot we're in survival mode. Backward acceleration is pretty decent as well. Side acceleration is also pretty decent. And I'm guessing downward acceleration is pretty decent as well. There you go. The turning speed of the... Well, it turns really fast. Alright, since you know this is a racing ship, we're gonna see how well I can drive down some canyon or something. Hold on. To change direction, I should always use the forward acceleration and not rely on the lateral thrusters. Come on. I'm gonna open the canopy. Oh, hold on a second. We actually still have enough thrust to dampen our fall here. Oof. Alright, one more try. I'm gonna keep on third person here. Yeah, this is actually somewhat easier on third person. Come on. One. Yeah, never mind. Flying in a canyon is kind of silly anyway. Let's see how well this thing can go downhill. Alright, here goes. Oh, when we lose power, the canopy hinge is no longer locked anymore. And there goes the whole vehicle. Is there anything left of the canopy? Yeah, there's nothing left of the bridge of the vehicle. I mean, of the cockpit of the vehicle. Yeah, if you crash on this thing, he'll pretty much get disintegrated. I guess the best weapons for this ship would be an auto cannon turret, because we will be able to dodge the enemy fire by, you know, going laterally. I guess I can put one more back here. There you go. Alright, let's see how well this vehicle can deal with an enemy base. I'm pretty confident about this one actually, because we have like a lot of forward acceleration. Alright, here we go again. But yeah, well, we actually won the previous battle. This is actually a really nice vehicle for, you know, for combat purpose, because you have a lot of acceleration, so you can easily dodge enemy fire and just kite the enemy turret like this one here. Hold on, we're gonna win this again. There you go. I think we disabled one of their turrets, I'm not sure actually. Almost there. Come on, we just gotta keep firing. Oh, what the hell? I saw an explosion. We just gotta keep kiting the enemy. We disabled another one of the turret, I'm guessing. I'm pretty sure there's still one more though. I'm not gonna go down there prematurely. Hold on, I guess I can get closer. I gotta make sure. Ooh, look at the damage on my canopy there. Come on. Yeah, that's... the artillery turret seems to be still functioning. I want to disable the artillery turret first before we stop the fire. Come on. by guessing this stuff, we're actually outturning the artery tart's ability to spin around. Come on, almost there. Oof! No. We lost one of the decorative elements. Yeah, as you guys can see there, the artery tart is really, really strong. Oh wait, are we winning? Did we win? No, the artery tart is still functioning. This is kind of like playing War Thunder actually. Let me get closer. Oh, gotta be careful with the handling. No, come on. Oof, that was close. Well, I guess the artery tarot is still functioning, but as you guys can see there, we can just outturn the artery tarot and sneak like behind or under the enemy base or whatever. So, you know, basically we win. Oh, the canopy has this gap by the way, so you can still get inside the vehicle even if the canopy is closed. So, you know, you're not gonna lock out of the vehicle. Oh, what the hell? And let's see how much damage we did to the artery turret. Oh, there you go, it's finally destroyed. That's one of the reasons artery turret is really great, by the way, because it's really strong as armor as well. Oh, what the hell, something exploded. Oh, no. But yeah, well, this is actually a rather decent vehicle. I mean, you know, because of the subgrids, it can be a little bit unstable, especially in gravity. But well, for the PCU, even though you don't have like survival kit or all the survival stuff, that's still a rather low PCU for what you're getting on this vehicle. And especially because of the acceleration, this can actually make a really good combat vehicle as well. And well, I guess the only other downside of this vehicle is the fuel time. Let's see how much fuel tanks we have in this thing. Two small hydrogen tanks. Yeah, the fuel time on this thing is not gonna be great at all. But still, I think this is a pretty cool vehicle. Say, this the Irgo by Oh My God We're Doomed. You guys can find the link in the description below. Now this is spot racing.